My name's Andrew O'Keefe. I'm a neurosurgeon and a neuroscientist, and currently we're at UCLA Medical Center, and I'm part of Dr. Nader Pouratian's laboratory, and we're studying movement disorders in human beings. We're particularly interested in a certain type of movement disorder, something known as Parkinson's disease, which is quite common. Parkinson's disease is interesting because we don't know why it happens to people. We know that we can correct it with an electrode in the brain, which passes a small amount of current into the tissues of the brain, and we can correct people's symptoms of their Parkinson's disease using this technique. It's called deep brain stimulation, and it's increasingly common in its use in hospitals these days. Our laboratory is the operating room, and what we're interested in doing is taking these patients with Parkinson's disease and treating them for their condition by putting electrodes in their brain. Now, that affords us the wonderful opportunity of taking recordings from the deep brain structures, from the places where we put those electrodes, in order to find out what's happening in that part of the brain at the time when we put the electrodes in.
All right, so we are going to get an x-ray now.
We have the patient awake.
Hi, everybody.
And behaving, so we can ask them to perform certain tasks for us. We have a very rich laboratory, if you like, in which to gather this information. What we can do is have the patient behave and look at the brain signals that they're producing at the same time, and we can try afterwards to relate those brain signals to the kind of behaviors that we're seeing in the operating room and try and figure out how the brain's producing those behaviors. So I grew up in Northern Ireland, in Belfast. I was first interested in science really as a very young child, when I just was fascinated by the things I saw around me. You figure out how plants work, the mechanism of photosynthesis, it's well understood. And it's fascinating, and it lends a richness to life that otherwise we would be completely oblivious to. My dad would bring back a pig's heart when we were young, and we would dissect it on the kitchen table and things. And it was great fun and interesting to see how it worked. And you don't realize it when you're 5 or 6 years old, but to have a consultant or an attending cardiologist dissect a heart for you and tell you how it worked is a great privilege and a great educational experience. For us, it just seemed like something fun to do with our dad. You know, science offers a whole exciting range of ways in which you can explore the world and test out your ideas about the world. And I've always been interested in how things work. And the ultimate challenge for anybody who's interested in how things work is, how does the brain work? What makes us human? The amazing thing when you're operating on brains is that you cut open the skin and you crack open the skull, and inside is this 1.5 kilograms of gray matter. And inside that is every thought, every emotion, every feeling, every sight and sound that anyone's ever heard. When you see the brain, the living brain, it's pink and it pulsates and it's living and alive, and that brings to life the fact that there's so much going on inside this organ that we don't understand, so much to discover. So what motivated me to engage with this particular field of research was, I came across some research about people putting electrodes into people's brains to get rid of the symptoms of Parkinson's disease. And when you see the videos of this procedure and how it immediately resolves their movement problems, it's like magic. And for me, that was a very attractive prospect. We took an engineering solution, we put an electrode in, a bit like a pacemaker in the brain, and we got this fantastic result. People were able to move again and speak again, hold their grandchildren, look after themselves. I didn't want to just study the brain from a distant perspective. I wanted to get hands-on, and I wanted to make a difference in people's lives. And I wanted to be the person that was in the theater, like Dr. Pouratian, doing those operations. It's a great environment to work in, a very stimulating, fun environment to work in, and a very, very much a team spirit.
Yeah, you can. It's very subtle, but it's perfect.
That's what I love about the surgery side of neurosurgery and neuroscience, is that we're all working as a team to figure out these problems and make these people better.
In 5, 4, 3...
We have a unique opportunity as neurosurgeons to look at the brain in a hands-on way, and in a way this curse of Parkinson's disease is a blessing for neuroscience, because we can study the brain as a byproduct of our clinical treatment of patients, and we can try and figure out how the brain's doing what it does. So long term, let's get rid of Parkinson's disease, but in the short term, let's figure out how the brain's doing what it does best while we're trying to cure this horrible disease. What I would say to anybody who's considering a career in science is abandon any preconceptions that you had about science. It's really a very diverse field. Whatever you're interested in, you'll find your niche. And so long as you have a curiosity about the world, that's all you need to drive you to be a very successful scientist in the future.